There is no one like you. There is no God like you. El Shaddai, there is no one like you. Some say you are good and you are kind, but there is no God like you. Some say you are big and you are strong, but there is no one like you. There is no one like you, Jehovah, there is no one like you. There is no one like you, El Shaddai, there is no one like you. Some say you are good and you are kind, but there is no one like you. Some say you are big and you are strong, but there is no one like you. Amen and amen and amen. Good morning, dearly beloved. I welcome you to Morning Dew Prayers this glorious day, Sunday, the 22nd of August, 2021. I declare over your life and your family the peace of God, and I nullify every evil deed that's working against you and your family. And beginning from now, there shall be a release of fruitfulness, of joy, of peace, of glory in your life, in your family, in the mighty name of Jesus. This morning, as you join us to pray, God will answer by fire. Your life will experience a complete turnaround for good, a positive turnaround, and your joy shall be full. You will live in peace, you will live in fulfillment, and great, great, great shall be your testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Very quickly, as we pray this morning, I'm going to read a scripture from the book of Philippians. I'm reading chapter 1 and verse 20. Philippians chapter 1 and verse 20. Scripture says, according to my earnest expectation and hope that is that in nothing I shall be ashamed, but with all boldness, as always, so now also Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. Praise the mighty name of the Lord. We're going to use this scripture this morning to pray. There's a lot of things that this scripture is speaking to us. We're going to pray a lot of things. We're going to start with expectations. We're going to look at the hope. We're going to look at shame. And we're going to look at what can magnify the Lord in our lives. And we just pray as the Spirit lead us. So this morning, I invite you to join us as we first of all thank God for life. Amen. There's so much news about people just passing on unto glory. And we don't even know if all of them are even passing on to glory. Because you can only pass on to glory when you live a life of Christ when you are alive. If you don't live a life of Christ when you are alive, there's no passing on to glory. Amen. So this season, we just want to thank God for life, that we are still privileged to be counted amongst the living. And where there is life, there is hope. Amen. And since you are still alive, there's still hope for you. So just go ahead and thank God. Forget about all the circumstance that is happening in you, all your expectations, all your needs that have not been met. Just thank God that there's life and there's hope and you have a future that is in Christ. Father, I want to thank you. Thank you for the grace and the privilege and your mercies that has kept us alive even till this very moment. We are grateful to you. We return all the glory to you. Thank you for our household. Thank you for our homes. Thank you for our children. Thank you for our wife. Thank you for our husbands. Thank you for our businesses. Thank you for the works of our hands, our careers, our education. Thank you, O Lord God, for the church of God. Thank you for our nation. Thank you for where we are living. Thank you for your peace, O Lord God. In the midst of chaos, thank you for giving us sound mind. Lord, we thank you. We give you all the glory. We appreciate you. Blessed be your name. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your provisions. Take all the glory. Thank you for last week. Thank you for the beginning of a new week. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. The next prayer we're going to pray is about our expectations. Most people may have some good expectations, amen, at one time or the other. And time appears to be running out. And you ask yourself, do I still hope or do I still keep hope alive? concerning this situation? Do I still wait on God? Am I just going to give in? You know, what should I do? But what the Bible tells us in Proverbs 23 and verse 18, that surely there is an end and your expectation shall not be cut off. To wait may seem endless, but when your morning comes, your joy will come. So we're going to pray. They're going to pray and say, Father, please restore my hope and expectations, and let there be a manifestation in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to make that prayer, amen, this morning. Father, please restore my hope and expectations, and let there be a manifestation in the mighty name of Jesus. All the things that we have been trusting you for, we have been waiting. You might be waiting for the fruit of the womb. You might be waiting for that visa. You might be waiting for that admission. You might be waiting for that job opportunity. You might be waiting for payments for work that you have done. You might be waiting for so many things, some promises, both physical and spiritual, that has come your way. Father, a lot of us have been waiting, and time appears to be running out. This morning, we cry unto you, let our expectations not be cut off. Please restore our hope in you, our expectations in you. Let it be a manifestation in the name of Jesus. In this season, let it be now. We want our morning to be now. Father, in your mercy, let our expectations be rekindled and let there be manifestations in our lives, in our homes, in our families, in the works of our hands, to the glory of your name, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Many a times when your expectation is delayed, it may lead to shame. Amen. Just like a woman who has been trusting God for the fruit of the womb, year one, year two, year three, and people have started to talk, you know, shame begins to set in because she feels incomplete and feels that her family is not the way she has expected. So when expectation drags for too long, it may lead to shame. And nobody ever wants shame to come near him or her. So we're going to pray and say, Father, every form of shame in my life on account of delayed expectations, please turn it around for glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Make that prayer and pray very seriously. You say, Father, every form of shame in my life and in my family on account of delayed expectations, please turn it around for glory in the mighty name of Jesus. You are the only one that can do it. You did it for Anna. Shame was her name. She was mocked and humiliated on a daily basis, and she cried unto you. You answered her prayers and you turned her shame to glory. This morning, we, your children, were crying unto you. Every shame on account of delayed expectations. My Father in heaven, please look on us with your eyes of mercy and turn all such around for glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it be so for every one of us. In Jesus' mighty name, we've prayed. Amen and amen. We pray and say, Father, whatever that has brought shame into my life and my family, please have mercy on me and let there be a complete turnaround in the mighty name of Jesus. Because shame might have come from something else. It might not be on account of delayed expectations. It might be things that we have put our hands into. It might be events that we have been connected to. It might even be because of the people that we are associated with. And shame has come to our doorstep. This morning, we're going to pray for a complete turnaround. I will say, Father, whatever has brought shame into my life and my family, my Father, my God, please have mercy on me and let there be a complete turnaround in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, let there be a complete turnaround. Lord, any shame that has come into my family, even if it's through someone else, because when people do certain things and you are part of the family, the shame of those people, they rub off on you. Father, this morning we are crying unto you. Every shame that has been brought into our lives and our families, by whatever reason, please show your mercy and let it be a complete turnaround. A complete turnaround, even this very moment, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. One of the reasons why our expectations appears to be cut off is when our faith begins to fail. Unbelief sets in. Amen? No, we no longer believe in God, or we don't even believe that God can do it, and we begin to seek help from the arm of flesh. Meanwhile, the scripture makes it clear that when you put your trust in the arm of flesh, you will fail. Amen? Praise the name of the Lord. So I'm going to pray and say, Father, in your mercy and grace, please forgive me for every form of unbelief in my heart. Spirit of the living God, rekindle my faith again in the mighty name of Jesus. You say, Father, in your mercy, please forgive me for every form of unbelief in my heart. Spirit of the living God, rekindle my faith again in the name of Jesus. You see, no one can play a package of the or cover the things of the heart. God sees the very heart of every man. He sees the intent of our heart. And many of us, our faith fails us. When the expectations begin to drag, we begin to shake. Our faith is shaking. And we begin to look to other means. We begin to look into what can I do? Who can I call? Who can help me? And we leave God away and we begin to find help from the arm of flesh. And this morning, we are asking for mercy, that the Spirit of the living God will rekindle the faith we have in Christ. Because once you have faith, it says it in Hebrews 11 verse 6, that anyone who comes to God must first of all believe that he exists. And is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. So that without faith, it now becomes difficult to please him. So we are praying this morning that the Spirit of God will rekindle our faith in God. And our faith will come alive. Father, have mercy on us. Forgive us from every form of unbelief in our hearts. And Spirit of God, Holy Spirit, rekindle our faith again in the name of Jesus. We pray and say, Father, today I put my trust and hope on you. Let there be a performance of your word in my life and in my situation in the mighty name of Jesus. You make that prayer, your next prayer. You say, Father, today I put my trust and hope on you. Let there be a performance of your word in my life and in my situation in the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, I want you to know that anything that you might be going through, anything whatsoever, there is a word of God that addresses that situation. All we need to pray now is that let that word of God, let it manifest, let it do something. Let there be a performance, an activation of the word of God in my life concerning that particular situation that we will be going through. Father, please, let it be so, O Lord. Let it be so, let it be so. Let it be a performance. As we put our trust on you again in our lives, concerning our family, concerning our children, concerning our business, our career, our destiny, Lord, concerning whatever is facing us, challenges, problems, court case, police situations, Lord God, deportations, whatever it may be, my Father, let there be a performance of your word in my life and in my situation, even today, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Jeremiah 17 and verse 5, it says, "Cursed is the man who trusts in man and makes flesh his strength, whose heart departs from the Lord." We pray and say, "O God of a second chance," you cry out to him, "O God of a second chance, please restore to me all that I have lost on account of looking to man for help rather than seeking the face of God." You cry unto God this morning and say, "O God, the God of a second chance, please restore unto me all that I have lost on account of looking to man for help rather than seeking the face of God in the mighty name of Jesus." So shall it be for us all. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Father, please arise for my sake and frustrate every plan of the wicked over my life and my destiny, and let Christ be magnified in my life. That's your next prayer. You say, Father, please arise for my sake and frustrate every plan of the wicked over my life and my destiny, and let Christ be magnified in my life in the mighty name of Jesus. See a man where Christ, or see a woman where Christ is magnified. Joy is a portion. Peace is a portion. You know, there's something that propels them. There is comfort. There is grace. There is strength. There is favor. There is the glory of God in their lives because Christ is being magnified in their life. My Father, my God, we pray this morning that you arise on our behalf and frustrate every wicked plan of the enemy against our lives, against our destiny, against our tomorrow. And let Christ be magnified in all our lives to the glory of your holy name in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray and say, Father, Please envelop my family and I in your mighty wings and keep us and keep all forms of death far from us in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray and say, Father, please envelop my family and I in your mighty wings and keep all forms of death far from us in the mighty name of Jesus. Keep death away from us. Envelop us in your mighty wings. Keep us, protect us, guide us, secure us in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen and amen. Finally, you pray the next prayer. You say, in all my dealings, Holy Spirit, help me to stay heavily focused in the mighty name of Jesus. I will tell you why you need to pray that prayer. Beloved, we are in the end time. Let no man be deceived. Amen. It is worse for you to discover that after now, there's life after death. People might tell you all sorts of things. Amen. But what will you gain when you find out that there's life after death? Amen. So we're going to pray that we'll be heavily focused. Let us be heavily focused in all our dealings, knowing that a time is coming when we'll surrender or when we'll give account of all the things that we have done here on earth. We'll say, Father, in all my dealings, Holy Spirit, help me to stay heavily focused in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. So shall it be for us all in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Thank you for another opportunity to raise our petitions before you this day. Please answer by fire and speedily too in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, please rekindle our trust in you and keep alive all our expectations in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, don't allow our hope in you, our expectations in you, to die on account of delay. Father, please keep alive all our expectations in the name of Jesus. Turn all our expectations into testimonies so our joy may be full in the mighty name of Jesus. This week, send angels to take charge over us all and give us victory on all sides in the mighty name of Jesus. Protect our home front from every form of attacks, whether it be physical attack, whether it be financial dryness, whether it be emotional trauma, or whether it be spiritual attacks. Father, protect our home front from all forms of attack all throughout this week and beyond in the name of Jesus. Let our week produce success. Success that are resounding in the mighty name of Jesus. We ask, O Father, that you place our feet in the places of success and peace. And please, my Father in heaven, fill us with your joy in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for you and your family. There shall be no untimely deaths in your life, in your family, in the mighty name of Jesus. And the blood of Jesus will avail for you, will speak for you, will defend you, will conquer for you, will make a way for you, and will cause you to live in the fullness of God in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen and amen. God bless you. Have a glorious Sunday and a blessed week ahead. Shalom.